Around the country, we're just hoping for any consequences whatsoever for the Republican politicians who have aided and abetted and agreed with and now apologized for those who attacked the Capitol. And hey, we kind of sort of have it. Some big companies are briefly pausing donations to politicians. So these companies fall into three broad categories. Those going after specific Republican lawmakers who voted against the certification of the presidential election. Those going after objectors in general. And those withholding all contributions for now, regardless of political party and whether a lawmaker participated in the effort. I'm gonna say for that third group, you deserve negative credit. For the rest of you, very little credit. But to give it really fast, and honestly, we have a lot of details and our producers did a great job putting it together. But like, I viscerally don't care about the details about what these companies are doing, but thank you so much for doing the production. Morgan Stanley is suspending all PAC contributions of members of Congress who didn't vote to certify the results. Dow is suspending all PAC contributions to any member who voted to object to the certification. It'll last for one election cycle, 2 years for representatives and up to 6 years for senators. AT&T did something, Hallmark is there. Hallmark seems okay generally, I don't know. Coca-Cola said in a statement that it would also suspend political giving. These events will long be remembered and will factor into our political contribution decisions. Facebook, no, I'm not even reading the graphic. Shut up Facebook, I don't care. I don't care what you did, you get zero credit. In fact, can we delete that graphic? I don't want it to be able to be read. But anyway, Jordan, how much credit do they deserve? What do you think?
None. This is a cynical PR ploy by people who had no problems any step of the way. They had no problems with archaic immigration policies, family separation. They had no qualms about jingoistic foreign policy or militaristic crusades around the world. They don't care about Republican efforts to deprive people of bodily autonomy and making reproductive choices. They don't care. In fact, many of them don't want you to have healthcare. They did want tax cuts and they got that. They had no problem with that. But now, when there's blood on someone's hands, how would we know? Despite this being the clear trajectory we were on to any rational observer. At the end of the day, they only care about profit. And there's a couple of different distinctions here. Some of them are making pauses for 6 months. What does 6 months get us to? The summer recess. When they come back from summer recess, they are in midterm. So they're delaying PAC contributions when nobody is campaigning. They aren't pledging to stop lobbying and they haven't made any concessions or comments on where money would be going regarding C4s. So they're still gonna pump money into super PACs, which you cannot then trace. But they're just not gonna give easily traceable and very small quantities, limited by law, several thousand I think is the cap, to a PAC, a candidate's PAC, which is already becoming antiquated for a couple different reasons. You know, the populist rhetoric in the country has successfully moved people away from direct campaign contributions. You know, obviously Cenk and TYT has been at the forefront of that issue for years, but now the right is starting to adopt it as well. It's limited by the tax code, so you can't really give much. You could give like, I think 5,000 or seven, something like that to a PAC. Unlimited amounts of money to a super PAC, untraceable. So they could just very easily flood super PACs with millions of dollars to get the same result, maybe even more successful, because then those PACs will run ads in support of these candidates. So it is a purely cynical PR play. They're gonna fund millions and millions of dollars into right wing PACs or super PACs and C4s. Just it is all smoke and mirrors.
Yeah, and you're 100% right for all of those reasons. But even if all of that wasn't true, they are limiting this donations when we are exactly as far from an election as you can ever possibly be in America. Like, we just had the special elections, like you don't get farther. And who thinks in 6 months they aren't all gonna go back to, like, sure, do the representatives want money now? Sure, but they're gonna want a hell of a lot more of it in 6 months and a year and a year and a half, I can tell you that. And I have a feeling Hallmark, who I guess gives, why is Hallmark involved in any of this? We all know, but and all that. But they're gonna be giving it again, which is why, like, I saw a comment on the Twitch from Picker Bell Pixie, who is an awesome person, and says this is still good because corporate money needs to get into politics. Picker Bell Pixie is obviously right in the overall goal, but I would say Jordan is right in that this is not what this is doing. This has, like, if you had a book on this, it would be filed in the library under corporate finance, I guess. But that is exactly as much as it has to do with their actual involvement in financing political campaigns. This is the easiest thing by far for them to get rid of. And it generates a little bit of positive buzz and everything, but that's basically it. It's basically it. How about this? If you're worried, if you're a corporation, a CEO, and you're worried that you're gonna donate to a politician who's gonna support an insurrection, I have an easy out for you. Get your money out of politics entirely. Don't lobby, don't donate anything. Just make your stupid cards and stuff. Do your business stuff. We'll take care of the politics. You go make donuts. I don't know what you do, but you shouldn't be donating. You shouldn't be running ads. You shouldn't be donating to super PACs and all of that. Just get your money out of politics permanently, and you can avoid all the insurrections.
Oh,
By the way, what, really fast, Pinkerbell Pixie says, yeah, I changed my mind after Jordan ranted a bit. But your goal is laudable.
That's great. It's just so cynical. And like they've done more to undermine democracy here and around the world. That just through corporate greed and profiteering. So this idea that they protect democracy. Do you want to talk about Facebook for a second? Do we have time? Because that's hilarious. Because I went on last night on Facebook to see if I could find information about protests on the 20th. And yeah, absolutely. You're still finding conspiracy theory and fringe rhetoric in Facebook groups. So it's hilarious that they're like trying to save face when they had no problem taking millions and millions of dollars from the Trump campaign and Republican politicians in ad funding over the course of the election. But now they're gonna pause direct very, very small contributions to campaign or candidate PACs for however long. It's so unbelievably funny because it's a cynical PR play.
Yeah. Or is Mark Zuckerberg the hero we need?
Oh yeah.
Anyway.
He's gonna save us all.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.